Hey, there is our friend Rod Gilmore of ESPN at ABC, a proud Stanford alum down on the field. And it's great to see you, Rod. Welcome.
Hey, thanks for having me. And look at you guys talking about defense, man. I love this.
Yeah. What do you want to think about all the years you've covered your alma mater and obviously watched closely as you've seen the last two seasons and the way the defense has turned? What would you like to see moving forward in 2023 from Bobby April's
group? Well, you know, really just that aggressive mentality that we were used to seeing here, where you really got after teams to stop the run. And I think, as you mentioned right at the top there, that's a critical component of things. So if we can't stop the run, things don't go well. And you saw that last season. So I like that emphasis. And to me, you know, the other thing that I was concerned about and I care about is the transition the players make with the new staff. Because I went through that when I was here at Stanford, a new staff. And it's a little bit unsettling because you have a staff that didn't recruit you. They didn't come into your home and meet your parents and all that kind of good stuff. But I have to tell you, I mean, I love what I'm hearing from the players here. I mean, Troy Taylor has done a tremendous job reaching out and connecting with these players. So I think the transition has gone great. And from the players that I've talked to, they have really connected with this new staff.
Right, you're a man that studies college football, the whole landscape of college football, and it's changed a lot lately with NIL and the transfer portal. Can Stanford keep up, being that they don't have that many transfers and they're just now getting into the NIL game?
Well, I think it depends on what the administration wants to do. If Stanford wants to go all in on NIL and career opportunities for players and internships and take a real academic approach to it, Stanford can do it. Stanford can do it better than anybody else out there. It is a question of what the university wants to do, how they want to participate in this market. And I don't think any Stanford alum wants to see Stanford go wholesale transfer portal. But, you know, the right 3, 4, 5 guys makes a lot of sense. So I think it's dependent upon the administration, how they want to handle it. But I firmly believe if they support Troy Taylor, you'll see Stanford football rise again pretty quickly.
Yeah, that's been part of the question, right, is the success under first Jim Harbaugh and then the incredible success under David Shaw. How does the program recapture that? And in comes Troy Taylor, a guy who's been in the league as a player, been in the league as a coach, and has had just an incredible amount of success as his time as a head coach as well.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about that. And the fact that he's bringing in a new offense, up-tempo, really going to stress the defense of other teams the way our teams have been stressed the last few years. There's no question about him and what he can do with it. It's a matter of the support and the changes in college football. We keep hearing about all the collectives and NIL. Stanford has one now, but Stanford needs more support on that front. And again, does the administration want to help and support and compete in this market? And I think if there's any amount of that, you'll see Stanford can do that whole game, NIL and career opportunities and internships. They can do it better than anybody else out there in college football.
Stanford versus Cal, one of the biggest rivalries in college football. You were on the field for the play, one of the biggest plays in that rivalry.
Yeah.
And now we've got a Cal guy as the head coach of Stanford football. How does that make you feel, Rod?
Well, who's writing the checks, right? I think that's pretty clear, you know. Listen, it's a great rivalry, and that play is one of the most iconic plays in the history of college football. You know, it wasn't great on that day for the 105 guys and coaches in the locker room with me, but we recognize where it fits in college football history, and, you know, it's a fun thing for the rivalry and the like. You know, we like to think that here at Stanford we've gone to a lot more Rose Bowls than Cal has.
Now back to present day, Rob. Yeah. What do you want to see from this Cardinal football team during the spring?
Well, I think first and foremost, everybody is curious about what happens at the quarterback position. You know, Ari Patu or Ashton Daniels, who's the guy that takes over there? Who do you have the most confidence in? And then I just want to see that aggressiveness, that quickness, playing fast, particularly on defense. You know, it seems at times last year we were a step slow, not in position, that sort of thing. So making sure guys know where they're supposed to be and that they're playing fast tempo on defense. I think we're going to be fine offensively. I think Stanford's going to put points up on the board. It's a matter of having the defense that can stop teams and give yourself a chance to win. Now, it may not be first week, second week, but as we keep going, that's really the critical thing. And that's what I've been looking for on defense here, how quickly our defensive linemen, our linebackers are moving, the safeties, and, of course, the corners. That's been a real key for me today. And Greg knows that. Greg knows that. You know, if the defense is a step slow, he's going to kill him.
Yeah, yep. And I'm looking at that offense. You're glad you got the eyes on the defense because I'm looking at that offense.
I got you.
Rod, it's great to have you. Thanks for jumping on.
Hey, thanks for having me, guys. And Greg, great job last night, by the way.
Oh, thank you, Rod.